Hello, Stat 200, and welcome to Lesson 2. This is the first of two lessons on describing data. This week, in the Lock 5 textbook, you're going to read sections 2.1, P.1, 2.2, and 2.3. This order matches the order that these topics are introduced in the online notes and covered in your Wiley Plus homework assignment this week. Let's begin by reviewing categorical and quantitative variable types. The visual representations and summary statistics that you use this week will be dependent on whether you have categorical or quantitative variables. A categorical variable has groupings, in other words, categories. These have no meaningful order of magnitudes or a meaningful order with unequal intervals, for example, rankings. These are also known as qualitative variables. A quantitative variable has numerical values with consistent intervals. This is also known as numeric or interval ratio level. This week, you're going to learn about visual representations and summary statistics that can be used with one categorical variable, two categorical variables, or one quantitative variable. Like last week, this video is not going to contain all of the content that is covered in this week's lesson. Instead, I try to cover the key topics that I think are most important because you're going to see them throughout the course. Let's begin by looking at one categorical variable. This week, we'll see three different visual representations that can be used with one categorical variable. We'll go through these quickly here. In your online notes, there are instructions for making each of these visual representations in Minitab Express. For one categorical variable, you can make a frequency table. Minitab Express calls this a tally. You could also make a pie chart or a bar chart. Note that in the bar chart, the bars are separated. This signifies that this is a categorical variable. In a few slides, we'll see a histogram, which is used for a quantitative variable where the bars touch. In terms of summary statistics, for one categorical variable, you can compute a proportion. A sample proportion is signified as p hat. This is computed as the number with the trait divided by the total number. For two categorical variables, in terms of a visual representation, you can construct a two-way table. A two-way table presents one variable as the rows and the second variable as the columns. You could also construct a clustered bar chart. In terms of one quantitative variable, you could construct a dot plot or a histogram. Note that in the histogram, the bars are touching. This signifies that this is a quantitative variable. We often look at dot plots or histograms and discuss the shape of a distribution. Here we have a symmetric distribution. This distribution is said to be skewed to the right. When we're talking about skewness, the direction of the skewness is the direction of the tail. A lot of students confuse right skewed and left skewed. In this right skewed distribution, we can see that there are more values on the left side with the tail pointing towards the right. In this left skewed distribution, we have more values on the right with the tail pointing towards the left. The direction of the skewness refers to the direction that the tail is pointing. This week, you'll be introduced to a special symmetrical distribution. This is a normal distribution. More specifically, this is a Z distribution. A Z distribution is a normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. This notation is often used. The N tells us that the shape of the distribution is normal. The first number in the parentheses is the mean, and the second number is the standard deviation. So this is a normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. The distribution that we see here is a probability distribution plot, so it's perfectly smooth. If we were to collect data from a sample and construct a histogram, the shape would not be perfectly smooth, but we would be able to see the shape of the normal distribution. In terms of summary statistics, one quantitative variable can be described in terms of its central tendency. This week, you'll learn to compute the mean, the median, and the mode. The mean is the average. A sample mean is signified as X bar, and a population mean as the Greek letter mu. The median is the value in the middle of the distribution. And the mode is the most frequently occurring. A quantitative variable can also be described in terms of its variability. You'll learn a few different measures of variability this week. The most frequently used is the standard deviation. While your instructor may ask you to compute the standard deviation by hand on your lab assignment this week, after this week, you're always going to be computing standard deviation and all of these measures of central tendency using technology, primarily Minitab Express. This concludes the Lesson 2 overview video. If you have any questions as you're working through this week's materials, please post them to the Lesson 2 discussion board on Canvas.